हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ वसंत धुमाळ, असिस्टंट प्रोफेसर ऑफ केमिस्ट्री एट राजर्षी शाहू महाविद्यालय लातूर। सो इन दिस व्हिडिओ वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टंट अँड इंटरेस्टिंग टॉपिक इन केमिस्ट्री, दॅट इज VSEPR थेअरी, व्हॅलन्स शेल इलेक्ट्रॉन पेअर रिपल्शन थेअरी। सो फ्रॉम द नेम वी कॅन गेट इट, दिस थेअरी इज अबाउट द इलेक्ट्रॉन पेअर इन द व्हॅलन्स शेल अँड देअर रिपल्शन। व्हाय दिस थेअरी इज इम्पॉर्टंट? So this theory help us to predict the geometry and shape of molecules just by counting the electron pairs. So the basic idea is that electron pairs around the central atom repels each other. Why? Because they are negatively charged. So to minimize their repulsion, these electrons are arranged in such a way that they get the minimum repulsion. So this arrangement give rise to the shape of a molecule. When we talk about the electron pairs, we know there are two types of electrons pair. First is bonding pairs and second one is lone pairs. So bonding pairs are those electrons which are busy in making bonds, and lone pairs which are not making bonds, right? According to VSEPR theory, the repulsion between lone pair is greater than lone pair bond pair, and the repulsion between lone pair bond pair is greater than bond pair bond pair. This is the strength of repulsion order according to VSEPR theory. So by the end of this video you will understand why CO2 is linear in shape, why H2O has a bent shape, NH3 has pyramidal shape. There are important questions also that are asked on this topic. Okay, to find out the shape and geometry, we first find out the hybridization of molecule. So there is a simple formula by which we can find out the hybridization of any given molecules. Formula is simple, that is Z is equal to number of valence electron of central atom. So we have to know the number of valence electron of central atom plus number of monovalent atom. So we know monovalent atoms are those which have only one valency, like halogens or hydrogen, plus minus charge divided by 2. So this is the a simple formula by which we can find out the total number of electron pairs. So by knowing the electron pairs, we can easily find out the hybridization, and from hybridization we can easily find out the geometry and shape of any given molecules. So here Z is electron pairs. So from formula we can calculate the total number of electron pairs, and after electron pairs we can easily find out the given molecule geometry and shape. So if the total number of electron pairs are 2, then the hybridization is sp hybridization, and sp hybridization has a linear geometry. If the total number of electron pairs are 3, then the hybridization is sp2 hybridization, and sp2 hybridization has trigonal planar shape or trigonal planar geometry. If the total electron pairs we get 4, hybridization of these electron pair is sp3, and sp3 has tetrahedral geometry. If the total electron pairs are 5, then we get the hybridization sp3d, and the shape or geometry is trigonal bipyramidal geometry. If there is a 6 electron pairs, then the sp3d2 hybridization, and the geometry is the octahedral geometry, right? If there are 7, then it is sp3d3 and pentagonal bipyramidal geometry. So from this we can easily find out the hybridization and geometry, and after that shape of any given molecules, right? So this is all about the electron pairs, their hybridization and geometry. So now we can take simple example. For example, NH3. Okay, so from NH3 we have to find out the shape of NH3. This is the formula by which we can calculate the hybridization and their shape. So here in this molecule, we know the central atom is nitrogen. So we have to find out the valence electron of nitrogen according to our formula. We know valence electron of nitrogens are 5 plus surrounding atom is hydrogen, which is a monovalent atom. So here, how many hydrogens are present? 3. So 5 plus 3 plus charge. In this given molecule, there is no charge. Directly, we can divide it by 2. Z is equal to 8 divided by 2, 4. So we know that if the total number of electron pairs are 4, then the hybridization is sp3 hybridization. So from sp3 hybridization, we know the sp3 has a tetrahedral geometry. We know there are total number of electron pairs, we get 4. So in this molecule, there are surrounding atoms are 3. One is lone pair present, that is on nitrogen, right? So we know the shape is pyramidal shape. And these are the lone pairs of nitrogen. So 3 bond pairs and 1 lone pairs together, we get the 4 electron pairs. So the geometry of sp3 is tetrahedral, but the shape is pyramidal shape of, that is of NH3 molecules. We can get another example. For example, BF3. So here central atom is boron. We know the valence electron of boron is 3 plus surrounding atom is fluorine, which is a monovalent atom. So here 3 plus 3, there is no charge on the BF3. So we can directly divide it by 2. So here we get 3 plus 3, 6 divided by 2, 3. So we know if the total number of electron pairs are 3, then the hybridization is sp2 hybridization, right? And when sp2 hybridization is present, then the geometry is trigonal planar geometry. So from this formula, we can find out the given hybridization, and from hybridization, we know the geometry of sp2 is trigonal planar. So here we get the total number of electron pairs are 3. So we know electron pairs are the combination of bond pair plus lone pair. So here in BF3 molecule, central atom has 3 surrounding atoms. So here only bond pairs are present, right? So here trigonal planar is the shape of given BF3 molecule. We know the trigonal planar shape. This is a simple trigonal planar shape, right? We can find out any hybridization of any given molecule. For example, here we know H2O molecules, right? From this molecule, first we have to find out which one is the central atom. So here oxygen is the central atom, right? According to our formula, first is valence electron of central atom. So we know oxygen has 6 valence electron, right? Plus surrounding atom is monovalent atom, that is 6 plus 2 divided by 2. Here we get the answer 4. So when total number of electron pairs are 4, then the hybridization is sp3 hybridization. And sp3 hybridization has geometry tetrahedral, right? But the shape of H2O is not tetrahedral, it is the geometry. What is the difference between geometry and shape? Geometry is considered of bond pair plus lone pair, and shape is considered of only bond pairs. So we have to find out the bond pairs of given molecules. So it is easy, just look at the surrounding atoms. So here there are 2 surrounding atoms, so there are 2 bond pairs, right? So from these 4, 2 are bond pairs and 2 are lone pairs, right? First, we have to draw the shape of a tetrahedral molecule. This is the simple shape of tetrahedral molecule. In this molecule, we have 2 bond pairs and 2 lone pairs. Simple, this and this one is the lone pairs. So from this, we can easily get the shape of H2O, that is a bent shape, right? Or it is also called as angular shape. So here these are the lone pairs of oxygen, two lone pairs and two bond pairs, right? So these are the simple molecules that we have discussed here. Plus, if we have a molecule like given XeF4, right? So here XeF4 is central atom is Xe molecule, right? So Xe atom has total number of valence electron is 8. It is present in group 18 elements, right? So it has valence electron 8 plus surrounding atom is 4. There is no charge. So divided by 2, here we get the answer 6. So when there are 6 electrons are present, electron pairs are present, then the hybridization is sp3d2 hybridization, right? So sp3d2 has octahedral geometry, but here total electron pairs are 6 and we get the surrounding atoms only 4. So 2 are the lone pairs, right? So for example, this is simple structure of or shape of octahedral molecule, right? So there are total 6 bonds present, but here we have only 4 surrounding atoms. So there are 2 lone pairs. So these axial atoms are actually present as a lone pair. So this is 1 fluorine, 2nd, 3rd and 4th. If we look at the shape is only considered of bond pairs. So we can here easily cancel the lone pairs, then we get the shape that is square planar shape. So XeF4 molecule has square planar shape. So we can easily find out the shape of any given molecule just by counting their electron pairs. So this theory is very much important to know the hybridization geometry and shape of any given molecules, like ClO4-, right? ClO4-. So here central atom is chlorine, so it has 7 valence electron plus. Now here surrounding atom is oxygen, so according to our formula we can only add the monovalent atom. So oxygen is not a monovalent atom, it is a divalent atom, right? So here we cannot add the surrounding atoms, but here there is a charge, that is -1. So we know when there is a -1 charge, we can add it as a +1 divided by 2. So Z is equal to 4, right? So from this we can get the hybridization is sp3 hybridization and the geometry is tetrahedral geometry, right? So here we get the 4 as a total number of electron pairs, and in this molecule surrounding atoms are also 4. So in this atom there is no lone pair present. The geometry and shape is same for the given molecule, that is tetrahedral geometry, right? Another example is, we know everyone that CO2, in CO2 the central atom is carbon. We know carbon has 4 valence electron, so 4 plus here surrounding atom is oxygen, which is a divalent atom. So we cannot add the monovalent atom. Also there is no charge. So it is 4 plus 0 divided by 2. We get the answer 2. So when there are 2 electron pairs are present, then the hybridization is sp hybridization. And we know that when sp hybridization is there, the geometry or shape is linear shape. Therefore, CO2 has a linear shape, right? So why CO2 is linear? Here we get the answer from VSEPR theory. So from any given molecule we can find out their hybridization, their geometry or their shape just by counting the total number of electron pairs. Another example, we can get PCl5. In this example, phosphorus is the central atom. So we have to know the valence electron of phosphorus, that is 5. Phosphorus is in nitrogen family, right? So nitrogen has 5 valence electron. Same ways phosphorus also has 5 valence electrons. So 5 plus, now surrounding atom is chlorine, right? So chlorine is the monovalent atom. So we can add, how many chlorine atoms are present? 5. So 5 plus 5 divided by 2, we get the answer 5. We know when the electron pairs are 5, then the hybridization is sp3 dehybridization. One s orbital, 3 p orbital and 1 d orbital. So from sp3d we get the geometry, that is trigonal bipyramidal geometry. So the geometry of pcl5 is trigonal bipyramidal geometry. So what is the structure? So simple, this is the trigonal bipyramidal geometry of given molecules. So surrounding atoms are 5. Here we get total electron pairs are 5. Then all are the bond pairs present. No lone pair is present on the phosphorus atom. We have a molecule given like SF6. Right. So in SF6, we know central atom is sulfur. So sulfur has how many valence electrons? In which group sulfur is present? It is present in oxygen family, right? So we know oxygen has 6 valence electron. So sulfur also has 6 valence electron, plus the surrounding atom is fluorine, which is a monovalent atom. So 6 plus 6 divided by 2, we get the answer 6, right? So here if there are 6 electron pair, we know the hybridization is sp3d2 hybridization, right? And if there is a sp3d2 hybridization is present, then the geometry is octahedral geometry. So it is very simple, right? So by using formula, we can easily calculate the given hybridization and geometry. So here surrounding atoms are 6, then all are the bond pair, no lone pair is present in these given molecules. So we get another example of a lone pair, for example ClF3, right? So we know Cl is the central atom, so it has 7 valence electron plus surrounding atom is 3 divided by 2, we get the answer 5, right? So here 5 are the total number of electron pairs. So if there are 5 electron pairs are present, then the hybridization is sp3d hybridization. And we know sp3d has the geometry trigonal bipyramidal geometry, right? But here the total number of electron pairs are 5, but surrounding atoms of given molecule is 3. Means what? These 3 are the bond pairs and 2 are the lone pair present on the central atom, right? So here we draw first, here we draw the structure of or geometry of trigonal bipyramidal. Central atom is Cl. Now surrounding atoms is fluorine, right? But there are 2 lone pairs present in these given molecules. So where these lone pairs are present at this equatorial position. So these are the lone pairs. So here 1 fluorine, 2nd fluorine and 3rd fluorine. So if we cancel the lone pairs, because in shape we only consider bond pairs. So if we cancel the 2 lone pairs, then the shape of given molecule is the T shape. Right? So the given molecule has a T shape, but it has trigonal bipyramidal geometry. So geometry and shape is different, right? So these are the examples of VSEPR theory, by which we can calculate the hybridization, we can find out the geometry and shape, and also a bond angle. Okay, so this is all about the VSEPR theory. Thank you.